You've seen a lot of things in your medical practice. Anything like the coronavirus before ever?
You know, we dealt with some epidemic diseases when I was back in the Army a long time ago, overseas. But this is something new in America. We've really never experienced this.
There was criticism toward the governor that some said he should have shut the whole state down sooner. What was your view on that? Because, I mean, you and I live in the panhandle of Florida, so we know it's very different than South Florida, Miami, and Fort Lauderdale. What was your view on that?
So I actually don't think so. I mean, I think he did it. He reacted appropriately and in a timely fashion. You know, up here in North Florida, we don't have a lot of coronavirus cases. Most of them that we do have came from somewhere else. So we're taking patients from hospitals in Georgia and Alabama that can't handle, that didn't have the level of acuity that some of our trauma centers did. But, you know, we're pretty spread out up here in North Florida, and it's a really very, you know, it is not that urgent for us to be isolated like in Miami or New York.
Even in the panhandle, everything is shut down. Rental properties are ordered closed. Beaches are ordered closed. Basically, a pharmacy and a grocery store is about the only thing that's open. The question is, your area, more than any other that I can think of, has been now hit with a double whammy. A little over a year ago, you had Hurricane Michael, one of the roughest hurricanes of all time, Cat 5 hurricane. Your district, hardest hit in America from that. Now the coronavirus, what kind of economic impact is it having on businesses and individuals in your...
Well, so you're very right on that. This is a double hit, and the people here feel it. Now, they're good people, they're resilient people, they're helping each other, but, you know, no fooling. Our businesses feel like they get clipped again and then again, and it's a tough thing. I think we bounce back. I think we're going to come back, but... You know how it is. It's those hurricanes take a few years to come back from.
You know, I think a lot of people don't understand that the areas that are resort and tourist areas depend so much on the revenue of service personnel, whether they're wait staff at restaurants, people who service the hotels and the motels. Major chains are down 95%, which is basically they're out of business at 95% loss of revenue.
That's right.
The bill that you passed in Congress, and I know that was something that you worked on to try to get it done, how does it help those individual workers, not so much the companies, the corporations, how does it help that guy who lost his job as a waiter at the restaurant or the housekeeper at the hotel?
So we put the money in that bill so that their employers would pay them, we'll keep them, because they're being paid by us. I mean, honestly, they're covered completely by us for at least 8 weeks, in some cases more than that. And we're hoping that will incentivize the employers to keep their employees.
Boy, I really hope so. And I think all of America is right now cheering when they hear you say that and hoping it. One of the medical treatments that has been at least tried out on a number of people, seemingly with great results, is the use of a malaria medicine. Been around the market for 70 years, a safe medication. From your perspective as a medical doctor, not just as a congressman, would you take that drug for coronavirus? Would you prescribe that drug if you had patients who had coronavirus?
I would prescribe it. I have prescribed it. I absolutely would take it. It's as you and I are old enough to remember when chloroquine was a common drug. As you say, it's been around 70 years, and you don't use it much for malaria anymore because malaria has become resistant to it. But it turns out to work pretty well. It's not like an antibiotic and a targeted antibiotic and infection, but it does shorten the disease and it also makes it shallower. And if you combine that with azithromycin, another common antibiotic and inexpensive drug, then the patients actually do quite well.
Final question, Congressman, do you think the House and the Senate will take up yet another major relief bill before this is all over?
Well, we're going to do some more. As a minimum, we have some technical corrections we have to address. But we're going to see what we did with this $2 trillion up front, see how that goes before we go put another $1 trillion into the kitty, I think. It's a big slug of money, but it's what it takes to jumpstart this economy. And it's worth remembering, it's worth saying to everybody, America is the best place in the world to be right now with the coronavirus. I mean, here's where we're going to do the cures. Here's where we're going to do the vaccine. You know, here's where the resources are and the great minds that are innovating the treatments for this disease. So, I think we should thank our lucky stars that we're in America.
You know, Congressman, I couldn't agree more. I think that being in America at the worst moment of our nation's history is still better than being almost anywhere else other than America. And thank you for reminding us of how God blessed we are to be in this great land. Delighted to have you here. Thanks for joining us.